Chikorita isn't the best Pokemon ever. I think we could all agree on that. If you look at its stats of Chikorita and its evolution line, are they good? Nope. Is it good at battling? Is it good in competitions? Nah. And also, its design isn't even that cool. You know, if you look at its design compared to like Lucario or Charizard, it's not really a cool design, but it does have a cute design. You know, it's really cute. Now, this video is going to be pretty much the reasons why I think Chikorita is like the best Pokemon ever. And yes, Chikorita is my favorite Pokemon. And yes, these reasons that I'm going to list off are like exaggerating and it's like really reaching out there. But you know, this video is meant to be fun. And if you guys disagree with me, that's cool. Leave it in the comment section. Most likely you're wrong, because Chikorita is number one in my opinion. Alright, so reason number one. If you look at the Johto region specifically, and if Pokemon like was real life and we all got to choose our starter Pokemon, you know, we'll pick like a Pokemon, we'll bond with that Pokemon, and we're not just going to be using it for battling, but we'll bond with it, you know, maybe train it, you know, chill with it, you know. Now, out of the Johto starters specifically, if you choose Cyndaquil and you play with it, cuddle with it, and watch TV with it, just imagine yourself on the couch or something with like your little Cyndaquil like on your lap or like on the side, and it gets angry, it's gonna burst out some flames and like burn you, burn the couch, maybe burn your bed. So Cyndaquil is kind of dangerous to cuddle with, am I right? Now Totodile, he's like a little crocodile alligator and he has like these really big jaws. If he gets angry, maybe he'll like bite you or bite like something you own, or maybe like its teeth are growing out and it wants to gnaw on something. You know, it could probably like break your shelf or your TV in half or something, because Totodile, small, but his jaws are really strong. And also, if you try to like give a hug to Totodile, he has those spikes on his back and you might cut yourself. Think about it. Now Chikorita on the other hand, man, you could cuddle with that guy all day long and he isn't gonna hurt you. Chikorita doesn't have like anything dangerous like on its body. It just has like a leaf on its head, and you could hug it, cuddle with it, and it's not gonna hurt you. Even if it gets angry, it's not really gonna do anything. It's probably gonna use some sleep powder on you, make you go to sleep. So it's not dangerous and it'll be, you know, just cute to have and cuddle with. And also guys, let me point something out. I do have some Pokemon plushies over here, but one plushie I have not gotten yet is a Chikorita plushie. And I'm kind of disappointed in myself because I really like Chikorita, you know, my number one favorite Pokemon, but for some reason I don't have a plushie of it. So if one of you guys out there wants to send me a plushie, pretty big plushie, you know, hit me up in the DMs, you know, we'll conversate, and you know, maybe you can send it to me, you know, for my birthday or something. I don't know, I'm just kidding. So anyway, reason number two why Chikorita is the best Pokemon, it is the underdog. What I mean by that is people always choose Totodile and Cyndaquil, and if you put all the starter Pokemon in a group, every other Pokemon is going to get picked first, and Chikorita most likely is going to be the last one or one of the last ones. So that's why I call it the underdog. Like, it's not popular, nobody picks it, nobody roots for it, no one cheers it on, it's just kind of the back, kind of like a loser, you know. But if you think about it, like an anime or like TV shows, like the main hero or the main character tends to be the loser, but in the end, you know, he like works hard, has determination, prevails, and becomes like the champion, the strongest character in the whole series. But the main character in anime usually start off like as the weak, nobody wants to talk with, and then they become like a badass. So Chikorita is like that guy, you know, nobody really notices it, but it has potential, you know. And I feel like if Pokemon was real life, all the Pokemon will knock each other out of the ring and Chikorita will come out on top. Who knows, right? Well, anyway, reason number three. So if we talk about the first generation of Pokemon in that series, when Pokemon first got released to the world and everybody knew about it, we knew about the legendary Pokemon, the legendary birds, Articuno, Zapdos, and Moltres. Everybody liked those Pokemon, they caught them, they're like, these are legendary, they're badasses, and there's only one of a kind. And then later, you go in the games, you go into the Cerulean Cave and you see Mewtwo. Mewtwo, ultimate badass, like the ultimate Pokemon in the game. Little did everybody know was that there was a hidden Pokemon in the games, and that was Mew. Nobody knew about Mew, like he was hidden. You had to like unlock him in like some weird ways using glitches. So Mew was hidden in the game. So when people first started discovering Mew, Mew became the legend. He was the legend. On top of Mewtwo, on top of the legendary birds, definitely the mythical Pokemon Mew. And we can all agree that Mew is pretty much one of the original badasses of the Pokemon games. And I don't really know of many people that hate on Mew, but pretty much what I'm trying to say is Mew, even though he's not like as strong as some of the other like legendary slash mythical Pokemon. He was the legend, the first legend. And the point I'm trying to get across is, if you take all the Pokemon numbers, like number one being Bulbasaur, and then you line them up in a line or like on a stage, Pokemon number 150 is Mewtwo, and standing right next to him is Mew. So Mew and Mewtwo standing next to each other on the stage, that makes sense. They're both badasses. But if you look at Pokemon number 152, who else is standing next to Mew besides Mewtwo? You got it, Chikorita. So if you put all these Pokemon number one until the current number of Pokemon in the line, and they're all standing next to each other, Mew will be standing right in the middle between Mewtwo and Chikorita. So Chikorita is a badass and one of the best Pokemon ever because he gets the chance to stand next to one of the legendary OG mythical Pokemon of the Pokemon franchise. Boom. I told you guys I'm exaggerating here. All right, so reason number four. If you watch the movie The Search for the Legend, there is a character in there. He is an adult Pokemon trainer. He's a badass. His name is Silver. And if you watch the movie before, you'll notice that his main Pokemon that he always carries on his shoulder, kind of like Ash, is Chikorita. So in that movie, Chikorita, you know, he's just chilling on this guy's shoulder. And some people have theorized that Silver is Ash's dad because they have like a lot of similarities, like how he carries Chikorita on his shoulder. So anyway, this character, Silver, he chose Chikorita to be his main Pokemon because he saw a lot of potential in Chikorita and he chose not to evolve it. And also, if you know a lot of trainers who use pseudo legendary Pokemon like Dragonite and Tyranitar, those trainers are badasses. Well, Silver, being the badass he is, uses Salamence. And you know, a trainer who uses Salamence is an obvious badass. He's up there. And he also decided to use Chikorita. So the opinion of a top trainer is also one of the reasons why Chikorita is one of the best Pokemon ever. So reason number five of why Chikorita is the best Pokemon. So if you read Chikorita's Pokedex descriptions, pretty much you can get an idea that Chikorita isn't really a violent Pokemon. Like, it doesn't like to fight. So if you send it out to battle, most likely it's not gonna want to fight. And according to the Pokedex, it will use like a pollen that it releases from its leaf, like a fragrance, that will pretty much make like the battlefield friendly. So if it has an enemy, it will release like this fragrance and the enemy will become friendly. So pretty much what I'm trying to say is Chikorita, it's kind of like a peacemaker, a pacifist. You know, it doesn't want to fight, it wants no beef. And if other Pokemon have beef with it, it'll take like that route of saying like, hey, listen, bruh, I ain't trying to fight you. Like, I think, you know, we should like calm down, talk it out, become homies. You know, like, what's the point of fighting? They just chill, here's some fragrance, and after we talk it out, then maybe we can be friends. So pretty much it releases this fragrance, the enemy comes down, and Chikorita talks with it or plays with it or whatever, and then they become friends. So Chikorita does not promote violence, it promotes friendship. And you know, we all need friends, right? So those were the reasons why I think Chikorita is the best Pokemon ever. I mean, yeah, they were kind of dumb reasons and I did exaggerate, but hey, it's my favorite Pokemon. And if Pokemon was real, I would definitely choose it as my number one. And if one of these days I'm having like a contest or something and I'm giving away like free tickets to Disneyland to you guys, and I ask you who's my favorite Pokemon, you guys, you know. If you don't, I'll be a little bit heartbroken because hey, I made a whole video about it, right? But anyway, thanks for watching the video if you stuck through it, and you know, I hope you enjoyed it. And if you want to see more videos like this, you know, let me know and drop a comment. Let me know who your favorite Pokemon is. All right, I'll see you guys in the next one. All right, peace out.